experience. And I will not fight in Air Force, I will not fight in the Ukrainian army. Would you consider fighting at the front line or maybe helping with the Air Force as your pilot? Ray, my cowboy, I spoke about it lots of the times. I don't have the military experience, and I will not fight in Air Force, I will not fight in the Ukrainian army. Yes, first of all, because of in lack of the military experience. Second of all,
I have a story. I will tell you a story. I have a friend. He got the military experience. He served in Ukrainian army, and later he went as a commercial pilot to fly for the SkyUp Airlines. He was the first officer there, and just recently he was taken to the Ukrainian army. And even though he got the pilot experience, they put him to the infantry, and now it's a big headache
to get him out from the infantry to the air forces. Why? Because this bureaucracy is terrible. Also in Ukraine, we are the ex-Soviet country, and this bureaucracy stuff haven't been changed for years, and it's still very stupid. So now to take him out from the infantry to fly jets or whatever, it's a one in a hundred chance, you know. And who did the job? HR, the human resource, and they select the people. So if I go to the Ukrainian army and say, okay, I don't have the military experience, but I want to be a pilot, they'll put me to the infantry, probably, yeah. Because they say, okay, we need the men there, and they don't care about your previous experience, they just put you, and it's a big problem. It's a huge problem for the Ukrainian army. If it would not be reformed, we're gonna lose many more people, actually. And I have a hope that in this month, our Minister of Defense, Reznikov, will be changed for Budanov. Budanov is, I think, more professional than Reznikov, and I think he will solve this problem and his deputies, because Reznikov deputies were actually arrested for corruption for the food supplies for the Ukrainian army. So we don't need this kind of old Soviet school, and we don't need corruption in the army.
We need proper people to fight in a proper way. That is why I'm not willing to join the Ukrainian army, because I'll be put just everywhere, could be put everywhere. They would not look at my previous experience. Also, if you don't have the military experience, if you don't have the lieutenant, lieutenant rank, you'll not be considered as a pilot or any kind of the aviation personnel or whatever, or the tank commander or even drivers. So for qualified job in the army, you need to be lieutenant, and that you have after serving 1 year mandatory in army for all of the men in Ukraine. But by the time the medical commission checked me for the army, I haven't passed it. By the time I had the problems, now I'm more or less okay. But back then I was 18 years old,
I had the problems, some specific problems, and that's why I haven't passed it. So that's why I don't have now the military experience. So there is no any chance for me to join the Ukrainian army in flying jets. Maybe the only way is like, okay, I will ask if I'll have the direct connection with the Minister of Defense or Zelensky. If I would like to, maybe I would ask, but no. And I don't have the direct connection. Hey man, I have been watching your YouTube videos every day for months now. Thank you for what you do. Thank you so much for watching me. Musashi, I hope I spelled your name correctly. You are helping the war effort by doing what you... Yes, we actually lost lots of the funds, my friends, to support Ukrainian army, and raise the awareness about this war from the Ukrainian perspective. So yeah, I do what I do. Thanks for your video, I watch them all the time. I hope you continue after the war. Yeah, but if the war is over, I'll have nothing to film about, so probably gonna film some live videos, travel blogs, whatever.
I will not fight in Air Force, I will not fight in the Ukrainian army.